I am Nigel Mansell, and I am Lotus.
I am Jean Alesi, and I am Lotus. Bienvenue chez Lotus.
Welcome.
I'm Robert Kubica, bit of Lotus.
Я Виталий Петров. I am Lotus.
Hello, my name is Jackie Stewart. When I hear the name Lotus, I think of Colin Chapman, obviously. And I think of Jim Clark, because he was the greatest driver.
Je suis Eric Boullier. Welcome to Lotus.
I am Bruno Senna. Bem-vindo a Lotus. Of course, for me, Lotus has a very special meaning because Ayrton raced there. It's been quite special team for him and obviously for us. Two great names coming together.
I'm Wolf Zimmermann. Willkommen in Genf.
I am Donato Coco. Benvenuti a Geneva.
I am Clive Chapman.
And I am Lotus.
Welcome to Geneva.
I am Danny Bahar. And we are Lotus.
We are Lotus, and we are in Geneva. Ladies and gentlemen, your host, Chief Executive Officer of Group Lotus, Danny Bahar.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Welcome. What more can I say? Let me use the, how to say, these few seconds and moments to think about the last, let's say, 6 months, which have been incredibly exciting for us. And before I go any further, I would like to thank you for giving us your time today. I know you are all super busy with a lot to cover, and I appreciate the interest you have in Lotus. I see some familiar faces here, so I know it's a welcome back for some of you. Those of you who were here last year don't need to play spot the difference to recognize the transformation the Lotus brand has undertaken in just 365 short days. And as I said before, what a year it has been for us. On 30th of September in Paris, we unveiled an entire new range of sports cars. An Esprit, an Elan, an Elise, an Elite, and an Etern, starting to come out in 2013. Obviously, as well as sheer excitement, understandably, there was some natural skepticism about the scope of this vision. But rest assured, we very well know that now our challenge is to deliver. Everyone on our team is excited, and you can really feel the energy and anticipation at our home in Norfolk. Here is a little something to remind you that our future is with us every single moment.
There is no other sports car manufacturer that has won so many titles.
British icon Lotus will be doing something no other car manufacturer has ever done before.
The idea is finally to bring Lotus back to its legitimate place.
What Lotus has achieved in the past 60 years is something very outstanding.
The Paris launch is a signal to the world that Lotus is back. The legend is reborn.
We can find our desires.
Was the dawn of a new era for Lotus.
I'm going in for the kill.
What a year.
Companies like to make a splash, and Lotus certainly did that today.
They unveiled 5 new cars at once, where most manufacturers would just unveil one.
When I sat in it, it reminded me of when we were driving them on Basic Instinct, and I had all 4 wheels off the ground going over those hills in San Francisco.
With the new range, we have captured the very essence of Lotus.
The steering is almost complete. Now the focus is on engineering.
So performance is key, and that is why we are developing our own engine. With the clever use of commonality, we can minimize our development work. These cars are much more than an incredible vision. They are reality, and they're coming to life.
Saw the rebirth of Lotus. 2011, the vision comes to life.
Lotus's new era going forward as scheduled, the real hard work is well underway. For anyone who missed the stunning new Esprit, the first of our new range to be produced, it will be here in less than 48 hours for the public to enjoy. But enough of the future talk. We shouldn't forget that we're living here and now. And trust me, the here and now has its own excitement.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are Lotus, and we are the Lotus Elise Club Racer.
Here's a car for everyone who felt that we were losing touch with our roots. Our exceptional engineers have put even the lightest of Lotus's modern cars on a diet and managed to shed a further 24 kilograms. The traditional Lotus approach of reduction and purity leads to one of the most iconic lightweight sports car around. For over 15 years, the Elise has become a legend in the sports car market, carving out a niche with a dedicated following of lightweight fans. And now, the new Club Racer will definitely give the lightweight lovers something to celebrate. The Club Racer is everything that's cool about the Elise. It's fast, it's raw, it's responsive, and it's a huge amount of fun to drive. But we're hoping it will appeal to more than just the purists. Hopefully, it will attract new fans too. This new model demonstrates once again just how versatile the Elise range is.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are Lotus, and we are the Evora S and the Evora IPS.
We presented these cars last year already, but they were a little lost amongst the hype around the rebirth of the brand. I want to emphasize their importance to us today. We love the Evora, and in your articles you have highlighted its wonderful ride, handling, and steering. And we adore the Evora S. It's the next level of Evora experience. It communicates with you even better. The suspension settings has been fine-tuned for added power and provides a higher degree of precise control. It responds even more to driver input. It's an instinctive car, believe me. The experience is pure. You won't realize what you were missing from your driving experience until you get behind the wheel of the Evora S. And the clever IPS version of the Evora allows you to switch between manual pedal shift and automatic drive modes. You also have the option of selecting the sport mode, which showcases the Lotus Sport driving experience, allowing the driver to really feel each gear shift and be in complete control of the transmission. It's been a long time since Lotus created an automatic, and we've spent a great deal of time refining this one to make sure that it perfectly complements the Evora drive experience.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Lotus Advisory Council members Bob Lutz and Tom Purvis, accompanied by Formula One legend Jean Alesi and Kourosh Mansouri. We are Lotus, and we are the concept Lotus Bespoke. Designed by Lotus, supported by Mansouri.
Put simply, this stunning Evora concept car demonstrates the scope of future Lotus customization and represents the beginning of a new tailoring strategy by Lotus. We are testing the water. Once we have your feedback, we'll decide on the next steps. So you're in charge. Our thanks go to Kurosh Mansouri, who created this car in record time. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are Lotus. And we are the Lotus Evora Enduro.
The Evora Enduro is the perfect example of race car, road car technology transfer. This race machine will be the base point from which the GT2, GTE homologated cars for endurance racing, such as the 24 Hours of Le Mans, will be built. As a GT4 endurance, this car has already achieved great success, including the Dubai 24 Hour race earlier this year, where Nigel Mansell's son, Greg, and Leo came third in their class. Let's just hope for more of the same with our other racing disciplines, which leads me nicely to the comeback of the year.